involves others in decision making. Remember we talked this morning about how you're going to get buy-in. Doesn't have to be my plan. Doesn't have to be my plan. So if I want to get buy-in here, a good leader is simply going to tell you where they want to go. And how do you think, what do you think we need to do to get there? I'm sort of making that sense, right? So that gets into that being able to, brainstorm kind of idea, right? Kind of throw it out there. This is where I think we need to go. They might have a general idea how they want to get there, right? But the more that I give up control, the more I'll get control. The more that I allow you to be involved in the process, the more likely you're going to come along. Just like I said this morning, your name's going to be all over that thing. And you're going to work really hard to make it work because your name's on that plan. Right?
You say planning for failure?
Yeah, absolutely. Although some people would suggest not to have a plan B. Not necessarily a plan B, but be prepared to modify. Be prepared to change it. That's sort of making sense, right? See, I don't believe you'll ever have 100% of the perfect plan. I think 80% is good enough. I think perfection is somewhat overrated. I think 80% is good enough. Let's rock and roll and go. And we could kind of massage this thing as we go along.